In his sorrow, Micah must have found comfort in the words of David in his great declaration of faith in the 27th Psalm. I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Micah's lack of confidence in mankind led him to turn more fully to God and to put his confidence in him. It was there that Micah was able to gain a new hopeful, joyful perspective. Therefore I will look to the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. As a result, he was able to pen his own confession of faith. Who is a God like you, pardoning iniquity and passing over the transgression of the remnant of his heritage? He does not retain his anger forever, because he delights in mercy. He will again have compassion on us, and will subdue our iniquities. He will cast all our sins into the depths of the sea. You will give truth to Jacob, and mercy to Abraham, which you have sworn to our fathers from days of old. Like the tender love of a mother for her child, our Lord's mercy is all-encompassing. His incomparable compassion comes from the womb. In his love we find that kind of safety and protection that a baby feels inside the womb of its mother. In the embrace of our Savior we find perfect peace, total rest, and complete care. Our Good Shepherd takes responsibility for our entire well-being. It is because of his great mercy that he takes pleasure in the salvation of sinners and not in their death. Micah lamented that there was no one righteous left in the land. He prayed that the Lord would be the shepherd over his own people. The Lord allowed Micah to see the day when his nation would be brought to repentance. Do not rejoice over me, my enemy. When I fall, I will arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord will be a light to me. I will bear the indignation of the Lord, because I have sinned against him. Until he pleads my case and executes justice for me, he will bring me forth in the light. I will see his righteousness. Micah saw the regathering of his people in the land and the rebuilding of the nation after their own time of confinement in a distant land. In that day when your walls are to be built, in that day the decree shall go far and wide. O afflicted one, tossed with tempest and not comforted, behold, I will lay your stones with colorful gems and lay your foundations with sapphires. God would take the rebuilding of his people upon himself. He will forgive his people and shepherd and care for his flock. The day would come when the Lord himself, the only truly perfect and righteous man, would give his life for the sins of mankind. So truth fails, and he who departs from evil makes himself a prey. The Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no justice. He saw that there was no man, and he wondered why there was no intercessor. Therefore his own arm brought salvation for him, and his own righteousness it sustained him. For he put on righteousness as a breastplate, and a helmet of salvation on his head. He put on the garments of vengeance for clothing, and was clad with zeal as a cloak. Jesus died for our sins, so that we could be declared righteous. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Christ's death was in our place and for our sins. If we acknowledge that we are sinners in need of a Savior and believe in Jesus and accept his atoning work on the cross, God counts Jesus' righteousness as our righteousness. This is the need of every sinful man. It is in the dark moments of our lives that God accomplishes some of his greatest works, and they will only last so long as necessary for him to complete them. As Israel themselves experienced, the judgments of God were designed to bring them to repentance. Our periods of confinement are for our good and for our growth. Just as the Levitical priesthood had their period of confinement at the door of the tabernacle, to prepare them for their great work of intercession on behalf of the people, the Lord would have his royal priesthood today respond to their seasons of isolation and confinement with joy, knowing that he is working a marvelous work in our day that we would not have believed though it were told us. May we step up to our intercessory role and pray as Micah prayed, that the greatest wonders of the relationship between God and his people would be realized in our day. May the glorious day of salvation come to the hearts of all mankind. For the great work of God in delivering mankind was accomplished on the cross and on that glorious resurrection morn. Before all your people I will do marvels such as not been done in all the earth, nor in any nation. And all the people among whom you are shall see the work of the Lord. For it is an awesome thing that I will do with you. There is no God like our God. May we trust him with all our hearts, and lean not on our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge him, so that he will direct our paths. We have nothing to fear, no matter how dark it gets, or how uncertain things may seem. The Lord will be a light to me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? May we rest in the finished work of Jesus Christ our Savior, as we wait upon the Lord with joy. Therefore the Lord will wait, that he may be gracious to you, and therefore he will be exalted, that he may have mercy on you. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are those who wait for him. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.